Bakker, the naturopath, thanks for coming back. Clostridium difficile, C-Diff. It's a very, very big problem in the States, particularly. It's bad in hospitals, like so many people. I think it's like now up to 20,000 people die per year from C-Diff. And most C-Diff comes from flipping antibiotics. So people get given an antibiotic, it wipes out their gut, then they touch a surface or get infected with C-Diff, this bacteria, and then it causes a problem, okay, a really big problem. And then, of course, they can't get rid of this C. diff. So what the heck are they going to do? Most of these infections occur in people over 65. I think like 80 to 90% of mortality from C. diff, a bit like COVID-19, seems to be the older population seems to get hit particularly bad with it. There's an interesting paper I read. There are many papers you can look at online. And in fact, they're starting to now talk about natural and novel new herbal regimes. May have a promising future, they say, when people like me have been using herbal medicines now for many, many years for all kinds of bugs, including C. diff issues, you know. So there are different types of clostridiums, of course, you know, that live. But Clostridium difficile infection can cause huge problems with people's colons, you know. So what are you going to do? How do you get on top of this problem? Probiotics. Are very, very clever to do. Usually what I do when I have a C. diff patient, the first thing I do is determine how bad the C. diff is through stool testing. We can actually see it. And we look carefully at the case to see how long the person's had it for, when did they come out of hospital, you know, how did they get the disease. But particularly the cause is the important thing. And you'll find in most cases it was from antibiotics. So microbial or fecal microbial transplant, FMT, definitely is promising for seriously bad C. diff cases. Some people have tried everything and nothing works. I do know of a few cases that have been very successfully treated of C. diff with FMT, fecal microbial transplant. So that's something that your insurance company you know, may talk to you about, or you may talk to your insurance company about it, because it's worth doing. It's not cheap. It's about 20 grand to do the FMT, and it certainly has a very, very good you know, effect on many C. diff cases. In fact, it's probably the only time I would recommend FMT would be with C. diff, because I have not seen FMT successful with any other kind of treatment personally. And I know many patients of ours that have undergone in the past fecal microbial transplant that had no success at all. Initially, they felt good for a few months, but then they went back to square one. You won't have that with C. diff so much, especially if probiotics are put in. So lactobacillus probiotics, there are various strains that are showing promise, but it's the strain is not as important as the fact that it's lactobacillus. If I had C. diff, I'd be looking at probiotics and enzymes. I'd be taking them three times a day. I'll also slowly be introducing perhaps yogurt into the diet and other cultured foods like that to slowly, slowly turn the gut right around. So how you're going to get rid of C. diff is through persistence, as through regular testing, and also seriously considering fecal microbial transplant, probiotics, and also looking at a product. I'm not trying to sell my product but I will recommend it. CanXida Remove has been successful with C. diff. Not all cases, but I've certainly helped several people in the States overcome C. diff by encouraging to go for FMT and then put probiotics on top of that. And then regularly take the CanXida Remove product, which is that novel herbal thing that they talk about in the studies. Okay, there are many different herbs that work for Clostridium. Medical doctors will never talk about these herbs, of course, because it's all antibiotics, antibiotics, antibiotics. But that's what got you there in the first place. Some specialists actually even encourage more antibiotics on top of C. diff. And to me, that's just stupidity. You know, putting more poison back in the body that got you there in the first place. So, yeah, make sure stool testing becomes, you know, a part of your future if you've got C. diff, because you want to look at counts, not just C. diff, but you also want to see where your beneficial bacteria are. So I cannot recommend highly enough to have a comprehensive stool analysis done. Remember, not just to look at that diff, but also to look at the whole balance of the bacteria, okay, in that colon, because you really want to know what's going on there. You know, what are the levels of bacteria in there? The highest bacterial concentration in the gut is in the large intestine. And that's what we want to really analyze with stool testing to determine where the balance lies, you know. And then that will help you a lot. And when you sit down with your practitioner, you can discuss the problem. And then he or she can say, well, look, Mr. Smith, I think this is a really clever thing for you to do. You need to eat more of these foods. And look at some of the best foods to eat for the bowel, for the gut in general. There are plenty of diet videos on this channel that can, you know, show you. There's also videos on fermented and cultured foods. There's videos on the dangers of kefir, water-based kefir, which many people end up really sick with. And I discuss all those things on this channel. So, but just letting you know, you can recover from C. diff in many cases. Of course, depending on age and complexity of the presentation of the case, younger people respond faster than older people. But yeah, just be wary of antibiotics going forward. If you've had C. diff from hospital particularly, my recommendation is to be really, really careful about ever going on to antibiotics again. Preferably not go on them in the first place, because then you likely may not have had the C. diff, all right? So that's my take on it for what it's worth. Thanks for tuning in. Subscribe, and also you'll get my free 17-page Candida shopping list. Thanks for tuning in.